It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Frisco, Texas. I'm here with the legendary cut man slash trainer, Stitch Duran. How you doing?
¿Qué pasó contigo, Blue? Before the cameras went on, this guy was all tranquilo and cool and calm. But as soon as the lights went on, he went to the Jimmy Blue.
It's lights, camera, action, man. Listen, it's Friday night. We just got through with the weigh-ins. I know you're actually working Jesse Vargas's corner, yes, along with Joseph Parker, you know, former WBO heavyweight champion. This is a stacked car. It's something that is zoned, and I know I spoke with Eddie Hearn earlier in the week. He mentioned that it's something that he envisioned when he created Matchroom Boxing and when he was bringing the zone here to America. Tell us a little bit about the fight card.
No, it's a tremendous fight card, you know, to bring out the Latinos as a group, right? That's what makes it real interesting, because all these guys on the card can fight, bro. And, you know, to be headlining with Jesse Vargas against Mikey Garcia, just, you know, it's a big accomplishment for Jesse to be here, Mikey, for all of us to be here representing the Raza where we go.
Well, listen, man, you know, Jesse Vargas is a two-time divisional champion. He's no slouch. He takes and fights anybody that comes his way. He's a great fighter. He's fought some excellent opposition, but as well as Mikey Garcia. You know, you got both guys kind of, I don't want to say it's a crossroads fight. Jesse Vargas does fight, you know, he fluctuates between 147 and 154. He took the opportunity fighting Mikey, going back down at 147. You know, you work in his camp, you being within his camp, how have you seen him as far as his motivation, his energy, and his preparation for this fight?
Oh, all super, you know. But in all fairness, I only spent like 2 days in camp with him because I was doing the bare knuckle fights. I was working with Tyson Fury and all that. But in those 2 days that I saw were kind of like the peak days. And he looked impressive, man. I told him, I said, you know, one thing that I noticed is your speed. You got a little quicker on your speed and your balance point. Is a lot better than I saw before, and Ernie Zavala is doing a good job with you, man. So yeah, expect to see an athletic Jesse fight.
Listen, man, you've been around boxing, you've been around the MMA, just the combat sports in general for many years. You know, this isn't your first rodeo, but you know, when you come out here, man, and you see the fight fans coming out, you see the energy they bring, the excitement that they bring. How does it make you feel, man, as a professional cut man and, you know, working the corner?
Oh, no, you know, this is what we live for. You know, I'm telling my my niece and my nephew here that, you know, this is the fun part, sitting down talking to Jimmy Blue and hanging out with my family. And, you know, that's the fun part. The fights, yeah, you know, at this point, so I do so many of them that they're not academics, but there's a system that I follow. So once I get in the dressing room, at that point, it's all business.
Listen, man, you mentioned that you worked Fury's corner this weekend against Deontay Wilder. That has the boxing world buzzing. Everybody from media just across the whole globe, man, is talking about the performance that Tyson Fury had, which was the performance of his life. You know, he came back, he bullied the bully. He went in there and he just completely dominated. And, you know, props to you, man, because, you know, even in the fight before the water fight, he suffered a nasty cut. And in this particular fight, he got the best of the best, and you were able to sustain everything, man. How was that victory for you, considering that you've worked with several heavyweights?
I know, it was tremendous. It really falls up on top of some of the accomplishments that I've made, you know. But working with Tyson Fury was a blessing. You know, such a good guy. And, you know, I like to work with good fighters that are good people, like Jesse, like Joseph, and, you know, Tyson Fury, good people, because everybody fights. So it's not so much about the fights, it's about the person that I work with. And
that's right.
And these guys were top of the line, but I see a major career for Tyson Fury go as long as you want.
You know, Deontay Wilder has been receiving a lot of criticism. You know, I tell everybody, this is his first defeat. You know what I mean? Some people are humble in defeat. Some people can at times, you know, they have excuses, or some people have, you know, legitimate injuries. Mm-hmm. What did you see from Wilder that surprised you?
That he didn't have a plan B, you know. With Tyson Fury, I showed up the last 2 weeks of camp because I was working the bare knuckle fights and other events. But I got to see him, like Jesse, when they started peaking. And everything that he did in the gym, he actually did in the ring. So I got to give credit to Sugar Hill, Andy Lee, for setting up that program, which is Emmanuel Stewart's program. And I worked with Emmanuel Stewart for 12 years with Vladimir Klitschko.
That's right.
So I know that system. And it worked, but props to Tyson Fury because he implemented it and he stayed to the game plan. That was by design.
What are your thoughts as far as the heavyweight division? I mean, like you said, you worked with Klitschko many, many, many years. He's a great champion. You know, you worked with Emmanuel Stewart. But, you know, now it's a new era. I mean, you have, you know, you got the Furies of the world, the Wilders. You got the Andy Reese. You have Joshua. You have Parker. You have
Usyk.
I mean, you got DeSora. I mean, you got so many great heavyweight fighters that any of them can take a loss. What's your take on the heavyweight division?
You said it best, man. You're good at what you do, bro. I'm telling you. You know, you have to do commentating on TV because really you're excellent at what you do.
I appreciate it. Thank you for the compliment.
Nah, man. I forgot the question. You got me so excited.
No, I was asking, what is your take on the heavyweight division?
I think, you know, the heavyweight division is always a special place, you know, and it's no different than every other division because of the size and what they can accomplish and all that. And to have a round robin with all these fighters would be awesome.
Let me ask you, you know, you've been in big fights. Which is the biggest fight you felt that you've worked? I mean, you've been in different atmospheres. You've seen, you know, you've been in front of 80, 100,000 fans. What's one of your most memorable fights that you've had the opportunity to cover?
Well, outside of Tyson Fury, that really falls up on top also. But Vladimir Klitschko, Anthony Joshua, you know, 90,000 people, Wembley Stadium. And I didn't get there. My daughter got married in Crete on Wednesday, so Thursday I flew to London, and I didn't see Vladimir until we were in the dressing room for the weigh-ins. And so he has a lot of confidence in me, and, you know, I spent 12 years with him, right? But I told him at the end, I put my hand on his shoulder. I said, look, don't worry about nothing tomorrow. I'm going to take care of you like you're my son. And I left. The psychology also is more as important as the mechanics of being a cut man. So come fight time, right before Michael Buffer does the announcements, I'm putting the final Vaseline on him, and he's this far away from me, and he says, you can call me son. That's in front of 90,000 people, millions of people watching around the world, and it was just between him and I. I thought that was a special moment. But I knew I got it in his head, and it was one of the best fights he's ever had in his career. Probably the best fight.
You know, with boxing, man, everything is you know, a lot of people always say boxing is dead, you know, but for the true hardcore boxing fans, everybody that follows the sport, you know, you have a lot of these young rising stars. You got guys like Virgil Ortiz, Teofimo Lopez, Ryan Garcia, Tank Davis, you know, Devin Haney, and Shakur Stevenson. I mean, the list goes on. Where do you see boxing in the next 10 years?
Oh, I think, you know, those guys you mentioned are being seasoned for 3 years from now going forward. They'll be the new generation of, of top fighters.
Is there any of them that stands out more than the other?
No, I look at personalities because everybody can fight.
That's right. So. Well, let me ask you this last question. I know you're busy. You're here with your family, man. I appreciate your time. You know, they're mentioning with this particular fight, it's going to, you know, Jesse came out and said it may be a potential Barrera versus Morales type of style.
Yeah.
You know, with it being a sold-out crowd, we're being here in Texas, primarily Hispanics, you know, how do you see this fight playing out?
Exactly that. It's going to be a barn burner. You know, they're both going to come forward. They're both going to throw chingazos. You know, like I was telling my family here, when I look at fights, I don't look at them as who's going to win, who's going to lose. I look at it as a probability of cuts, damage being done in a fight. And I'll tell you this, I'll be prepared for worst case scenario.
My last question for you is, if there's any inspiring trainers, anybody that's looking to get in the fight game, or, you know, you got a lot of these guys who've worked in boxing many years and been cut men, and, you know, what does it take to get to the level where you're at?
Experience. You know, there's a lot of guys that call themselves cut men that, because you wrap a good hand doesn't make you a good cut man. You have to understand the mechanics of what a cut is, how it bleeds, what can you do to stop it, what are the medications you use, you know, all that has to, you have to know that stuff. And the only way to work on a cut, or to learn to be a good cut man, is work on a cut and progress as you go. But a lot of these guys, first time they work on a cut, they freak out.
Well, you know, before you become a master, you have to have a mentor. Who's one of the guys that in your lifetime, you know, growing up, has mentored you to get in the position where you're in?
Good question, man. I think you're good, bro. Chuck Bodak. You remember Chuck Bodak in the old days? Used to work with Julio Cesar Chavez, Oscar De La Hoya, would put the tape. Looked like Colonel Sanders, right? He was my mentor. You know, he's the first guy to welcome me to Las Vegas when I worked the big fight with Raul Marquez from Houston, fought Keith Mullins. And Raul had a bunch of cuts, five cuts, and defended his title. So that was my coming out party. But Chuck Boda, very instrumental. And then we did play it to the bone together. He was in the corner with Antonio Banderas, and I was in the corner with Woody Harrelson. But I wanted Antonio Banderas because he was Latino, right? Well, Chuck got in front of me. But Woody Harrelson's the one that got cut. I'm the one that got all the accolades. So it worked out good.
Listen, man, we appreciate your time.
No,
like I said, it's an absolute honor to get a chance to speak to a legendary trainer like yourself. You're a stand-up man. We appreciate your time. Is there any last shout-outs you want to give to any of your friends, any of your family, anybody that's back home and watching?
Not so much shout-outs, but what's been going on in my life, man. You know, like I say, I was just telling you, I grew up as a farm worker, you know, in the San Joaquin Valley of California, picking tomatoes, peaches, cotton, apricots, nectarines, grapes, you name it, I picked it for you.
Wow.
But now here I'm at this level, right?
That's right.
And but I just teamed up with Mark Zucker with an apparel company that they used to sponsor me before called One More Round. And Tyson Fury let me make an outfit for his fight that had the One More Round on it, and then my sponsors. Because if you remember when I left the UFC, it's because of sponsors. I got my sponsors back. So anyway, Jesse Vargas is doing the same thing. So he's letting me. I created an outfit to represent his colors, and
that's awesome.
You'll check it out tonight, man. But tomorrow. But anyway, go to onemoreround.com and check it out, man. That's my new venture, and you know I'm working with a CBD science company that's created a cream for the healing process of cuts once they get sewn up. Then we've been getting test results from the bare knuckle fighters. So, doing a lot of things, man.
Well, listen, man, we appreciate your time again. It's your boy, Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, signing off.